I'd never painted it on the Perspex, the clear plastic, before. And with a cling film, you can't really touch it because it's one layer thick, so the slightest touch will rip it, and it, because it's there's such high tension, it will just tear itself apart. But with this, it's so forgiving. You can get in and you can scrape and smear and scratch. And so I'm totally experimenting with this piece. I had the idea of what I was going to be painting, but it turns out how I'm actually going about painting it is nowhere near how I'd imagined I would paint it. You know, I don't have to be so guarded. Well, no, I don't need to be guarded at all. All I need to do is kind of keep within the lines, but there's so much maneuver space in there, like wriggle room, and like start like getting like bits of card and my fingers, painting my fingers, you know, like just smacking the Perspex, and it kind of like blurs the paint. So yeah, I'm having a time of my life on this. The reason I've made a bus stop is because I cannot drive, so I have to get a bus everywhere. So I spend half my life in buses. In buses and in bus stops waiting for buses. And you hear interesting conversations and you see people kind of in the bus stop, kind of like all staring blankly out, kind of like fish. And so when I started to design it, and I was put the fish, the 3D model of the fish in my 3D mock-up, the negative space of the tank, it's like I could really use that for interactivity. So I'm gonna paint like transparent turquoises, like water effects, so people will still be able to see through it and be able to press up against the glass, almost like they would a fish tank, and then be able to go inside it and like pose around the fish, you know, and have some real fun with it. It's a very tactile sculpture. It's not meant to be behind cordons, you know, it's not meant to be at arm's length. I want people to get in there and have some fun with it, and you know, just, you know, like misbehave, you know, because you go to so many galleries and stuff and it's so sterile, and it's everything you can't get, you can't touch. It's like, say, don't touch this, don't touch that, and I see that and I just want to touch it. So like with mine, I encourage people to actually get in there, touch it, and you know, pose with it and press up against the glass, put their cheeks up against it and blow their cheeks out, you know, like the wood. And so I imagine it will appeal to children as well, you know, rather than, you know, having a rotting diver's corpse in there. So kind of, I don't think that would draw in the sort of the younger crowd. I don't know, maybe these days it might.